for this record, there's more of a feeling of space. There's also a feeling of lusciousness and layers that people, I feel, coming from the States tend to think about more. There's a bit of a pop element, but a kind of Americana pop element that I never existed before, because it doesn't really exist in Canada, and it's certainly not over here. But working in a place like Los Angeles, which is so funny, because it's quite fake as well as destitute, it's a strange sort of mix. There's this quality of pop and of space. I don't know how to explain it any better than that. I feel like there's a sound of space that exists that I've never had before.
C'est aussi la première fois que vous co-signez toutes vos chansons avec un musicien américain qui s'appelle Joel Scherer, qu'on connaît, qui avait réalisé l'album de Mélanie Laurent il y a quelques temps.
Making this record, it was a difficult time. My last record was inspired by a breakup. This one, I was in the midst of a very difficult period of time, and the label and everybody said, okay, well, we need you to make new music. And the idea of having to make any music by myself, I couldn't. I had no inspiration. I was depressed. I was in a really not good place. And I said, okay, if you need new music, I need somebody to work with. And so Jacques suggested Joel, and I sent Joel some of the demos that I had for some of the songs on this record, and he said, they're pretty cool, let's talk. And we talked over Skype. So I took a flight down to Los Angeles, and we met in person and then just started writing. And we realized we wrote really well together. But, you know, I love collaborating, and I collaborate with Joel again, and I've met some other great people through him that I'd love to work with. So it was a good experience, but it was very new for me.
Le paradoxe avec ces chansons-là, c'est que ce sont à la fois les premières que vous enregistrez et composez avec quelqu'un, mais aussi les plus personnelles que vous avez faites depuis le début de votre carrière aussi.
It was good to have somebody else sitting there to objectively look at the situation and say, well, what do you mean? It's almost like a therapist. So it wasn't so much me being myself, but it was a great experience to learn how to look at a situation objectively without just being this ball of emotion, which is a really valuable life lesson.
L'instrumentation a changé, beaucoup plus riche sur ce disque. J'entends des cordes, des cuivres. C'était votre volonté aussi d'enrichir le son?
It was Joel. I mean, as the producer, he was primary arranger. I mean, obviously, he's like, what do you feel about this? So yeah, my input was clearly involved. You know, it was great. What I wanted when we were sitting down to talk about the kind of record that we both wanted to hear and the kind of record I wanted to make, it was kind of combining Tom Waits, Radiohead, with sort of a strange, you know, I don't want to say, like Memphis Minnie, sort of this kind of weird earth roots, but with a lot of different layers and different instrumentation coming through, but that still had a bit of a folky pop vibe.
Et quel est votre espoir avec ce disque-là?
My hope with this record is that it brings a bigger fan base, that more people can be touched by it, and that it gets me more shows back in the US and Canada, as well as actually playing all of the festivals I see in France that I'd love to play, but I don't get to play. Because I'm moving out of the jazz world, so it's exciting. We'll see. I have great hopes. Hopefully a lot of people will actually hear it. But I have no idea.
Merci beaucoup, Ndidi.
Merci à vous, Olivier.
À bientôt.
Oui, je sais.